आकाशातम प्रतिद्योत्यम यथा गच्छति सागरम सर्वदेहं नमस्कारम केशवम प्रतिगच्छितम। आकाश से गिरा हुआ जल जिस किसी भी प्रकार सागर को ही जा मिलता है, वैसे ही किसी भी रूप की उपासना एक ही परमात्मा को पहुंचती है। गुरुकुलम द श्लोका लर्निंग सेंटर is the place where you need to send your kids to learn shlokas. That is what I did. Gurukulam has been founded by Divya Dorai Swami, who is a shlokapreneur, economist, and loves to laugh. And she has been making me laugh ever since she's joined the meeting. That's wonderful. And aapka bahut bahut swagat hai. Divya, how did it all start? Tell us about Divya, the shlokapreneur. Over to you.
I turned 40 and I worked really hard to restart my career after very, very many failures. And I'm so glad about the fact that I've bounced back so well with the help of my family and God, that Gurukulam is going places. And I'm proud of the fact that I'm the founder of Gurukulam. Gurukulam was founded in the year 2014. I started with 6 kids. And today, I have around 95 children across the world. Name the country, and there is a child from that country. In India, there are kids from Rajkot. There are kids from Kerala. There are kids from Calcutta and Bangalore, Chennai, Delhi, everywhere. And when I talk overseas, I'm talking France, I'm talking Switzerland, I'm talking Netherlands, I'm talking US, UK, Canada, Singapore, Malaysia, every part of the world, UAE included. So I am really proud that I founded Gurukulam. It's a passion transformed into a profession. And the main aim of my school is basically to keep traditional roots in place. And we want to tap an area which was left untapped, that's shloka education. So we have a lot of music schools, we have a lot of dance schools, we have a lot of art schools. But you know, there was not something like a shloka school. Of course, there were a lot of people who were teaching shlokas, but I wanted to bring that through the use of technology. That means a child should be able to learn shlokas from the comfort of their home. So that's the whole reason why an online shloka school was set up.
So many years, I have never heard a shloka school. I mean, this is a wonderful concept, I think. So Divya, tell us, what is the uniqueness of this shloka school? Like, I think it's one of its kind in the whole world because I've never heard something like this. So let us know that how do you train kids?
Gurukulam is the first of its kind online shloka school that caters to kids across the world. And the main aim of the school is to keep traditional roots in place. Okay? So we're trying to hold on to our culture. When I started Gurukulam, I started off with 6 children. Like many other forms of art where people really take interest in, okay? But over time, I realized that parents, as I started putting up advertisements in small shops, in boutiques, in sweet shops, I realized that the interest was a lot more than I actually imagined. So the number of kids who slowly started joining Gurukulam was basically through a word of mouth or through Facebook ads. We are unique because we are curriculum based. So everything is based on a set curriculum. A child learns only from the curriculum. So that's one thing about Gurukulam. And second thing is all the 90 children do one-on-one sessions with me. I don't have group sessions at all. No group sessions. Because the whole idea was, see, there are fast learners, there are slow learners. And the idea was to give every child the same kind of learning. The idea was to impart the same kind of knowledge, and every parent should be happy when they come back to the second session. So when I say that, it's not just about extending shloka education, for me, it was about a parent also getting their money's worth. So if I was to, today, you know, if I was doing a group session, I probably would have had more than 1,000 children. Let me tell you frankly, okay, for the kind of popularity Gurukulam has. But I think I wouldn't be doing that kind of justice to a child if I did that in a group session. So that's the whole reason why our school is a one-on-one, you know, imparting knowledge on a one-on-one basis. So we're working on reading skills of children. And a child who's 4 years old or 4.5 or 5 years old, eventually over 6 months to 8 months, we see that they're able to read a book which is of an 8 or a 7 year old child. So that's like a milestone for me. We're working on reading skills. We had to make prayer time a part of a child's daily life. You know, they watch TV, they play games. There's so much of screen time. But I realized that gratitude, giving back to God, was very, very important. And that was possible only by giving 10 minutes of prayer time every day as a part of your daily schedule. And that's the whole, today I would say that all my kids have made prayer time a part of their daily life. And I'm very, very, very happy and proud about the fact that we've been able to instill that one practice in a child every single day.
And I think it's wonderful because starting early, I think, is the best way to, you know, inculcate sanskar. Request Divya ji to do these sessions for the elders as well.
I also do it for the elders. I have a couple of CEOs who are part of it. I have a couple of professors from top institutions who are a part of Gurukulam. Okay. It's not just limited to children, but of course, 90% of my time is given to children. I definitely work with elders as well. I have kids as little as 2 years and 8 months who start. And I cannot tell you how well they learn when they start as young as 3 years. They're, because anything that's put into their heads at that little age, their grasping power is fantastic.
And I think that is absolutely beautiful what you and how you're putting. Earlier, you know, in the old times, they used to say that a woman is pregnant. She should be reading out Ramayana, Mahabharata, Ramcharitmanas. You're doing a beautiful work, you know, Divya. God bless you for this. So, Divya, how important is traditions for the new generation since you are dealing with the children?
A country where there are such beautiful temples, right? India is definitely a Punya Bhumi. You're learning from so many different beautiful cultures. And the fact that children learn about all this is such a beautiful way of holding on to our culture. The whole idea is to hold on to our roots, our traditions, because it's lost somewhere. I really think somewhere we've lost it. Okay. For example, if I ask a child, you know, when they start a class, there are many parents who tell me that, Divya, my kid knows nothing in Sanskrit. My kid knows nothing in a shloka. I just tell them that you don't need to know anything. Just come and join. And, you know, you don't need to know Sanskrit. I'm not an expert in Sanskrit. I've learned shlokas over the years through my very, very trying times. You know, I've been through a lot of depression. I've been through a lot of anxiety. Nothing, you know, medicines didn't work for me. Medicines or yoga, nothing worked for me. And the only thing that probably worked for me was shlokas. I Googled shlokas. I would find out what is the shloka that will help me come out of a particular situation. And the magical shloka was the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. There can't be a simpler shloka than this, right? But the results are magical. It's magical. I cannot tell you how I pulled myself out of depression and anxiety by chanting this mantra regularly. I'm so grateful to God. I'm so grateful to my spiritual guru. He is an American. His name is Vic Tikara. Can't believe that it's an American who actually introduced me to the Krishna movement. So I'm grateful to him. So festivals, as we all celebrate a lot of festivals in our country, our children, the children of Gurukulam, have made it a point to participate in every festival in their household. They chant mantras, they take part in making sweets with their parents, they take part in decorations, they take part in rangoli making and everything. So that makes me such a happy teacher. We have a very interactive session. My shloka classes are not just about shlokas. We learn a lot of, they're very informative, you know. So if I'm teaching a shloka about Lord Narasimha, so I tell them who Lord Narasimha is. I tell them he's an avatar of Lord Vishnu. He's the half lion, half man god. He's a face of a lion, he's a body of a human. And a lot of information, like there are forms of Narasimha, Ugra Narasimha, the Yoga Narasimha, the Lakshmi Narasimha. So there's a lot of information that goes to learning when a child is doing a class, besides learning a shloka and the meaning. So we're not just about learning shlokas. We do a lot of reading skills. We're working on memorizing skills. We're working on speech improvement. There are a lot of kids. I work with a lot of kids who come with, speech difficulty. So over a period of time, as they keep chanting the Hayagriva shloka or the Saraswati shloka, the Vakdevi, so we see improvement. What therapy cannot do, we've seen that. So,
and I think this is beautiful because, you know, only a few who can connect well can do this. Divya, share with us some achievements.
The very fact that I started in 2014 and we're still in the market till 2020, the fact that we're going strong, and I think we're here to stay for a longer time, one. Second thing, I started off with 6 kids today with 95 kids, all one-on-one sessions. It's like a good growth, I would say. I've been the woman entrepreneur 2020 by the Inside Success magazine. We made it to the jury shortlist of the Times Award. Okay, and apart from that, we've been in over 50 publications, you know. To name a few, CNBC TV 18, Femina, Times of India, Hindu, New Indian Express, what else? Shiro's. Women Shine, everywhere. We're just there everywhere. Google has a lot. I'm very proud that, you know, you search for Divya and you find Google has so many results. Okay, that really makes me happy. But achievement for me really is, or success, I would say, is making an impact in a child's life. If I've made a small impact in a child's life, that's true success for me. And in 2020, we also made it to the Thrive Global, a part of the Huffington Post. Yes, Gurukulam found its mention. Gurukulam and the Shloka Praneo website found their mention in the Thrive Global.
Okay, so Divya, what next for Gurukulam? What are your future plans? I want to know also, is this an online school? It has been an online school, or you have your own academy?
We are an online school only. Registered online school. And today, all the kids just do classes through Skype or WhatsApp videos.
So, Divya, what are your thoughts on women empowerment and how are you supporting it? Let's hear about that.
I think all of us as women face some kind of issue on a daily basis, you know. It can be on the personal front. It can be on the professional front. As entrepreneurs, I think... there is lack of self-confidence. There is many times a fear that, you know, we are not getting the money that we probably need to get to run our businesses. See, entrepreneurship is a lonely journey. It is. See, when you're successful, it's a different story. But till you take off, it is definitely a lonely journey. And it's easy, I guess, for any of us to put down somebody else or even... mock at somebody's failure, because I've been mocked at. People have put me down because I've been through a divorce and they never thought, you know, that she will bounce back, or she, you know, people will talk. people will talk, you know, and you cannot stop them from talking. But all you can do is, at least having been in that journey, the difficult part, I think the first lesson that I learned as an entrepreneur was to empower or encourage women who are building their entrepreneurial journey. You know, all you can tell them is, of course, there are going to be tough times. There are going to be difficult times, but you will see light at the end of the tunnel. You'll have to push yourself. And we should also stop mistreating other women. And I think the first thing that we need to do is stop comparison. If you have to do that, you know, you'll have to constantly work on yourself to probably be a better person tomorrow than you were actually today. So that, instead of comparison and competition, I think if we work on ourselves and being a better person, I think we're doing a lot of good to ourselves and people around us.
You know, there is a saying that because we've learned to stay hungry, so we know the value of food, you know. So this is what, yeah. So I think Divya is more like the genuine Divya. I think that's the new name I'm going to give you, the genuine Divya. You know? So Divya, what is the success mantra? Like how, because you've said this many times that you rebounced and, you know, you came back to life again. And so what is the success mantra? What keeps you happy each morning? Let's hear about that.
See, first thing is, I live with my parents, okay? Amazing people. Totally fun dad and awesome mom. I have an amazing, fun, adorable sister, great brother-in-law, and a darling niece. Okay, they all live abroad. But, you know, I wake up to my niece, talking to my niece. So that's like my start to a day. You know, it can be at 5:30, 5. Anytime we're texting each other, that's how we start. I start my day. And I think, I told you, the Hare Krishna mantra, Maha Mantra is a part of my daily schedule. And it really makes me a very strong person. The person I am today is a lot because of God, you know. I definitely pray a lot. Whatever I am today is because of the role of God, you know, the power of the Supreme High. I think it's huge. It's huge. I don't think I could have moved forward without his blessing. No. And my success mantra is simple. I've transformed my passion into my profession. That makes me a very happy person. Very, very happy person. Because I'm doing what I like. Gratitude is such an important part of my life. I think the more I feel grateful to everything I have today,
and as rightly put by you, happy people are successful people because they have achieved what many cannot. I think that's wonderful, Divya.
So I'm very easily reachable. We have a website. It's www.shlokapreneurdivya.com. shlokapreneurdivya.com. I'm reachable we have a Facebook page, Gurukulam, the Shloka Learning Center, and Shloka Pranav Divya. And I'm reachable at Divya, DIVYAA1980@gmail.com. So anybody can reach out to me and write to me about what you all think, what you all want to, how we can improve on our services.
आप जो भी चाहते हैं कि आपके बच्चों की स्पीच इम्प्रूव हो, श्लोक सीखें, हमारी ट्रेडिशंस और जो भी हमारी किताबें हैं या जो भी हमारी सीक्रेट बुक्स हैं उनसे वो श्लोक सीखें, प्लीज गेट इन टच विद दिव्या. आई थिंक शी इज अप्रोचेबल. यू कैन कॉल अस आल्सो.
राशि, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर हैविंग मी ऑन योर प्लेटफॉर्म. फर्स्ट, सेकेंडली, आई एम सो ग्लैड आई कनेक्टेड विद यू. वी शुड स्टे कनेक्टेड. थैंक यू एंड नमस्ते राशि. थैंक यू.